Hello and welcome. Schönen guten Abend. Wir freuen uns sehr, dass so viele gekommen sind. We're very happy that there's so many people for a very special evening. Ein ganz besonderer Abend heute Abend. Die Ehrenpreisverleihung. Wir verleihen den IFFI Award of Honor, den IFFI Ehrenpreis, an einen Gast, der schon öfter da war und auch öfter nicht konnte, weil er immer so viel dreht. Now you're finally here. We're very happy. The IFFI Award of Honor tonight goes to Goran Paskaljevic. And we also have another very special guest tonight. Wir haben noch jemand anders Besonderen da. Klaus Eder, der uns die Ehre gibt, heute Abend die Laudatio zu halten. Vielen Dank, dass du da bist, Klaus. Bitte komm zu uns.
Treppen im Dunkeln sieht man nicht.
Kann ich loslegen?
Ja. Guten Abend. Ich würde zunächst einmal, ich werde nicht lang reden, weil Goran ist hier und der Film ist hier. Ich wollte zunächst einmal dem Festival danken, diese Ehrung zu machen und seine Filme zu zeigen. Goran hat, I should now change to English, right? Okay. Goran once said that to be a Serbian filmmaker in Europe is very difficult. He managed it. He is a Serbian filmmaker in Europe. His films were screened at the major festivals in Cannes, in Berlin, in Venice, in Toronto, in San Sebastian. They won prizes. He won almost all prizes possible. Nevertheless, it's difficult to be a Serbian filmmaker in Europe because somehow, at least I'm from Germany, in Germany we have the prejudice that a film by whomever, Goran Paskaljevic, is in the first line a Serbian film. And Serbia is a country which is not in the European Union, and it's not a complete democracy, and it has a terrible history, so it's a Serbian film, be cautious. It's wrong, of course. But we have to change this word of Goran, I think. It's not only difficult to be a Serbian filmmaker in Europe, it's a problem to be a Serbian filmmaker in Serbia. He has passed through very different periods of the history of his country, from Tito to Milosevic and later. And as a critical intellectual, he mixed in, of course. And at the time of Milosevic, he was opposing the regime openly, which was not undangerous. He said that Milosevic is not democratic. He is, he said some very right words against Milosevic. And the system answered. It was in 92, and the biggest newspaper at that time, Politica, wrote against him, and they collected opinions of readers, and the next day these opinions were published in the newspaper, and it was, he's a traitor, shortly, head up, kill him. And the only possibility for him was to leave his country and to continue his work abroad. He made some films in other countries, but he is very much linked to his country. He is a Serbian filmmaker, and the history of Serbia is his main subject. So wherever he was, he made a film in Ireland called How Harry Became a Tree. It's an Irish film. And yes, it's also a Serbian film. And years later, he managed to go back and to mix in again in the history and in the in his country, the politics of his country, by making one film, which was one of the best films ever made on the situation in Belgrade. For me, still one of your best films, Goran, called The Powder Keg. There's another English title called Balkan, Cabaret Balkan, something like this, which is stupid because it's really the powder keg. Powder keg is you put some fire and it makes an explosion. What do you see in this film? You see a everyday life stories. A young boy is taking some gas from a car and people are following him as if he would be a murderer. Two friends are having an argument. One friend kills the other. And later on, he kills himself with a bomb in a train. Very small things make a big explosion. And this was not only a story of a film. It was an analysis of the situation in Belgrade at the time. And the powder keg was not the story. The powder keg was Belgrade. And the powder keg was Yugoslavia. And the powder keg was the whole Balkan. And I think there's one thing he was not against or he was not for any regime in his films. He was never making a documentary approach in his feature films. But he felt the inner life of the people. He felt the psychology of the people. That's what he made in his films. And a few years later, and the situation in Yugoslavia had changed totally. He made another film called A Midwinter Night's Dream, where he went a little bit outside of Belgrade. And the story is that a man comes back, comes to his house. His house is taken by a woman and her daughter. And the daughter is autistic. And you don't have any more the big life of a big city like Belgrade. You have the periphery, and it's empty, and big tristesse in the photos. And here he showed how the aggressivity some years ago in Powder Keg changed to a social melancholy. Nothing moves anymore. This is how he commented his country. And the fact that he showed an autistic girl in that film as one of the main characters means, as a metaphor, this country is autistic, the people are autistic, this is the state of affairs in my country. He showed all this also via the actors. This autistic girl was a real autistic girl, and he managed somehow in a wonderful way to work with her. But there's one actor which I think is very essential for you. It's Lazar Istovsky, who is playing in the powder keg exactly the man who is killing the friend. And in the Midwinter Night's Dream, he's playing the main man coming back from prison, going home, being totally disillusioned. I think that these two characters in two films, and it's for me still the best films, or most effective of your films. He managed to show this Lazar Istovsky as a real Serbian character. I think if you want to know what is Serbia, there's one small scene in A Midwinter Night's Dream where Lazar Ristotsky is visiting his family, and that's a big feast, and the family is there, and they have a good atmosphere, and they're eating, and they're drinking, and they're dancing, and there's music. This is not the Serbia of Goran. His Serbia is in much more in Lazar Ristotsky, my God, what a name, and how he feels the political situation. What I wanted to tell you is simply that Goran is very much connected to his country, even if the country changed a lot. And he is one of the few filmmakers who take cinema as a social responsibility, as an engagement. He is, with his films, a critical voice of his country. And he once said that the beauty of a film is its closeness to life. And that's exactly what he has managed to do in all his films. They give us a big, big, big and near impression of a life in a country which is near but is still very far. Thank you very much and welcome Goran Paskaljevic.
To say something? Good evening. It's the third time that I'm here, and it's, I hope, not the last time. I just came back from India, from Himalaya, 7 days ago, and I finished my new film there. So I keep working in Serbia. I cannot to say that this Himalaya film is very Serbian film. It's not at all. But also was amazed by India, and I discovered some social problems there. And I would like to promise now that next year we will show the film here if you like it.
Well, we will see. Yeah, my dear Goran, I'm so very happy to have you here. Mir fehlen die Worte.
He's lacking words.
And
You are so eloquent tonight.
Isn't he?
Nein, wir haben viele Filmemacher hier gehabt, denen wir diesen Preis auf Honor übergeben haben in den letzten Jahren, die einen Namen haben in der Filmwelt, wie Shashi N. Karun aus Indien letztes Jahr und vorletztes Jahr Paul Le Duc, dann Janine Meerapfel im Jahr 2012. Da muss ich dazu sagen, dass Janine Meerapfel wurde am Wochenende gewählt zur Präsidentin der Akademie der Bildenden Künste in Berlin. Und darauf sind wir besonders stolz und wir gratulieren ihr. 2011 war Daniel Diaz-Torres aus Kuba der Ehrenpreisträger. Er ist mittlerweile leider gestorben und hat den letzten Film zusammen mit einem Filmproduzenten in Salzburg gemacht. Das war die erste österreichisch-kubanische Filmproduktion. Im Jahr 2010 war Fernando Piri, der argentinisch-kubanisch-italienische Filmemacher, der Ehrenpreisträger. Und angefangen hat alles im Jahr 2009 mit Gabi Geist, die auch im Raum sitzt, eine Schauspielerin, die 17 Rollen bei Herbert Achternbusch ausgehalten hat. Es ist einfach eine Ehre für uns, dass du hier bist, und es ist eher eine Ehre für uns wie für dich, dieser Preis.
Ich verstehe nicht.
Okay, now for you.
But I hope you said something nice about me. Okay.
Yes, it was. Please, no. Don't worry. We've had other recipients of this award of honor, and they were last year Shaji and Karun, in 2013 Paul Leduc, in 2012 Janine Merapel, who was elected president of the Akademie der Künste in Berlin last weekend, so we're very happy with her. And 2011, the recipient of the IFFI Award of Honor was Daniel Diaz-Torres, who unfortunately passed away. In 2010, Fernando Biri. And it all started with our lovely Gabi Geist, who was our presenter the award, the opening ceremony on Tuesday. And we're very happy to have you here, Gabi. But now you are finally here, and very happy about that too. You're very special to Helmut, and he was very, very nervous, and very much looking forward to meeting you here. And
ja, deine Filme haben mich immer sehr emotionalisiert.
He was always very emotionalized by your films.
Und ich habe deine Filme eigentlich überall gesehen, in den letzten in Goa, in Indien. Du kannst dich erinnern.
All over the world he saw your films, the last one in India, in Goa.
Und eben, deine Filme passen überall hin.
Your films fit everywhere.
Und ich habe mir überlegt, was ich dir schenken kann.
And he was wondering what to give you tonight. Something special.
Und ich bin wahnsinnig emotionalisiert von der Rede von Klaus Eder.
Now he's also very emotionalized because of this lovely Laudatio.
Diese Rede ist auch ein bisschen ein Geschenk von mir an dich.
And
obwohl ich sie nicht gehalten habe.
And Klaus Eder's speech was Helmut's gift to you.
Weil auf mich reagiert er ja nicht ganz gleich, aber wenn ich sage, Goran ist irgendwo, ist Klaus Eder sofort da. Komm her, Klaus.
Klaus only said he would come when he found out that you would come too.
Einfach wunderbar, was du gesagt hast.
Thank you.
Und es kann niemand besser sagen, und ich bin fasziniert, dass das gelungen ist, dass du heute hierher gekommen bist.
Mein Vergnügen. Für dich.
It's always nice to see you, Goran. Und ich bin zum ersten Mal hier beim Festival, und ich finde es ganz toll, was die Arbeit, die ihr macht. Was ich bisher gesehen habe, ist einfach ganz toll. Danke.
Klaus Eder said he loves our work and he's very happy to be here.
Aber das größte Geschenk macht uns Goran, indem er uns seine Filme zur Verfügung stellt, die wir hier euch zeigen können. Und wir haben leider nicht den Platz, also alle Filme zu zeigen. Er hat, glaube ich, 16 oder 17, am 17. arbeitet er gerade. Und wir werden natürlich wieder auf dich warten.
We're very, very happy to have you here tonight. And eight of your films. We would love to be a bigger festival with the ability to show more films. But we think eight films is quite a start, and of course we will show your films in the future.
Aber Sie müssen wissen, Goran ist für mich ein Teil der europäischen Filmgeschichte, und es ist nicht einfach im Übergang der analogen Filmpräsentation zur digitalen Filmpräsentation alles, was er gemacht hat für uns, zu bekommen, so dass Sie das auf der Leinwand sehen können.
Since you are such a European filmmaker, it wasn't an easy task to find all your films and getting them here, especially because of the transition from analog to digital film. But we managed, and we're quite happy that we will be able to show the majority of films on 35mm, proper archive copies, so it makes it even more special, I guess.
Ja, und also wir haben gemeinsam versucht, die Alissa und ich. Alissa ist ja auch aus dem Ex-Jugoslawien. Ja. Und sie war sehr engagiert, gute Kopien zu finden von deinen Filmen.
He said that Alissa is. He said that since I am also connected to ex-Yugoslavia, I was very committed. It was very important to me to get proper copies to Innsbruck. I didn't want any other copy than the best.
Wir haben in dieser Retrospektive Filmkopien gefunden in der alten analogen Version 35mm. Und ja, also ich hoffe, Sie haben Zeit, auch andere Filme zu sehen. Heute gibt es When Day Breaks, den Film, den ich von 2012, den ich in Indien gesehen habe. Und es gibt in den nächsten Tagen die Möglichkeit, mit Goran sich zu treffen und mit ihm zu sprechen. Und ich möchte ja eben noch einmal einen Satz aus der Laudatio wiederholen, weil er mir wichtig ist. Und Klaus Eder sagt eben, dass Goran Geschichten, wo immer er sie auch findet und verfilmt, mit der Geschichte seines Landes aufs Engste verknüpft sind. Eben dies macht ihn zu einem wahrhaft europäischen Regisseur, und zwar einem der Besten. Und für mich ist er einer der Besten. Und es gab auch einmal eine Umfrage in der Hollywood-Zeitschrift Variety, das ist die größte Filmzeitschrift der Welt, glaube ich, im Jahre 2002, und die haben gesagt, dass er zu den fünf besten Regisseuren der Welt gehört. Aber darum geht es mir nicht, sondern es geht mir darum, dass ich jedes Mal, wenn ich einen Film von Goran sehe, tief beeindruckt bin.
I understood most of it.
Okay. Yeah? Yeah. Just for the English-speaking people, maybe I'll repeat. Just quickly, you will have the opportunity to see seven more films after this evening, his latest film from 2012, When Day Breaks, and then within the next 3 days, seven more films. And we're very happy that Goran will be available for Q&As for the audience, so you can meet him and talk to him after the films. And Helmut finished with a quote from Klaus Eder, which is really important for him. The stories which Goran Paskaljevich finds and puts on screen are tightly linked to the history of his country. This makes him a truly European filmmaker, one of the best.
You have here many people in Innsbruck, they love you, and I love you the most.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Danke. Just a few words. Klaus presented me as a very much political filmmaker, which I'm not. I just follow the destiny of my people through my stories, and the politics influence the ordinary lives. But I understood everywhere in the world, so that I have this courage to go some other places. You didn't mention the first Albanian-Serbian co-production I made, Honeymoons. This film is also here. But just a few words, because I'm really exhausted, and they invited me for a glass of wine, and then after that I'm not ready for Q&A. But I will be for the other films every time present and open to your questions. Just to tell you a few words about this film, which is not typical films of mine. It's very quiet. And I just make a film about one concentration camp which exists in the heart of the Belgrade. And even 90% of the people from Belgrade don't know anything about this camp. And I felt some kind of shame, because that's the only Holocaust place in Europe which is not properly marked. And 6,000 Jews lost their lives there, and then that became a camp for all communists or the others from all the Yugoslavia, and another 15,000 people died there. So I made this film because I just felt shame. Nothing's unfortunately happened. After the film, the authorities said, yes, we will make a kind of memorial, etc. But every year they come, they took photos for the newspaper saying that they will do something, but they are not doing anything. So this film is a kind of memorial to those dead people there. And all the places you will see here, and some characters, they are real. So it's a very near to the documentary, in a way. So enjoy the film, if I can say that for this film. But hope to see you, some of you, after some other films. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Klaus. Thank you, Alicia. Thank you, Goran. Thank you. Have a good evening.